Hey everyone, this is the third part of our tutorial. You can watch it after mastering the first two parts. And if you succeed, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, so as not to miss new videos dedicated to Rubik's Cube and other puzzles. At the next stage, we have to assemble the yellow cross on our cube in such a way as not to destroy anything else. The cross looks like this. And as always, we have several possible situations. In this case, there are four. As you can see, around the central part of the yellow side, there can be different positions of yellow edges. For example, when around the yellow center all four yellow edges point in yellow upwards, this means that your cross is solved. And in this case, we just skip this stage, but there are some other situations. Let's start with the simplest. When around the yellow center there are two yellow edges out of four that stand in such a way that we can draw a line like this, we have to do the following algorithm. First, this line should be kept not vertically, but horizontally. This is such a minus or dash. And do the next algorithm. The first move that needs to be done is we turn the front face, that is in front of us, clockwise. After that, we do a right sexy move. And turn the front side back, that is, we turn it counterclockwise. As you can see, we already have a cross of yellow details, that is, around the central part, all four edges are yellow. I remind you that at the stage of solving the cross, we ignore the position of all corners, we look only at the edges. The next situation is when around the yellow cross, we also have two yellow edges, but they don't draw a line, but such an angle. In this case, we must hold the cube in front of us, so that one part looks up and the other to the left. Imagine that this is the watch face and your watch shows 9 o'clock. We do a completely similar algorithm with one small nuance. Repeat after me. We turn the front side clockwise and do a right sexy move. And then one more sexy move. Then turn the front side counterclockwise. As you can see, again we have solved a yellow cross. I remind you that we ignore the position of the corners, we look only at the edges. And the last situation is when there is not a single yellow edge around the yellow part. In this case, we first make the first algorithm. Imagine that we have a stick and turn the front side. Right sexy move, return the front side back. And then we have this situation. We take the cube in the correct position. I remind you, 9 o'clock. And we solve the second situation, namely the front face, two sexy moves. Return a front side. And we have solved a cross. And for the third or fourth time, I remind you that it doesn't matter what our corners look like. We ignore them. Let's try to determine which algorithm it is. If we don't look at the yellow corners, but only at the yellow edges, we will understand that this is a situation called line. We hold it horizontally, turn the front side, sexy move, turn it back, the cross is solved. If we don't look at the corner here, but only at the edges, we understand that this is the second situation, namely the front side, two algorithms, and turn back. And if we don't look at the corners here, but only at the edges, we understand that this is the third situation. First, we turn a front side, one algorithm, turn back, and then again, it's a 9 o'clock situation. Because we are not looking at corners, only at edges. In this situation, we turn the front side, two sexy moves, and turn the front side back. Well, folks, I congratulate you. There are only two stages left to a fully solved Rubik's Cube in your hands. And the task of this stage is to turn a yellow cross to a completely solved yellow side. Let's start with two basic and very simple algorithms that we will need at this stage. I also want to note that at this stage we have to look only at the yellow parts. And if you look closely at the yellow parts from above, then the shape will remind us of a fish. Here is its head, this is its tail, and it swims, for example, in that direction or in the other. But I remind you that we are looking at all yellow parts. And as you can see, in addition to the picture above, we have some more details on the sides. And they will help us determine which algorithm should be done at this stage. Let's start with the simple. The next algorithm is called Sune. How to determine the type of Sune? If we take a cube in such a way as if the fish floats to us, slightly tilted, and look from the front, we can see yellow parts not only from above. If the yellow part is on the right, then this is the right Sune. And if the yellow part is on the left, then this is a left Sune. Let's start with a right Sune. If the fish is looking at us, then this is a part on the right. So this is a right Sune, and we have to do this algorithm with our right hand. We hold the cube so that this part is on the right. Then, right hand, take the cube in this way and repeat after me. Right side clockwise, top side clockwise, right side counterclockwise. Top side clockwise, right side clockwise. Then we turn the upper side twice clockwise and turn the right side counterclockwise. As you can see from the position of the right Sune, this algorithm completely solves yellow color. Let's try to solve it again. Take your Rubik's Cube by any part, no matter where the details are. We will just study this algorithm. Repeat after me. It is quite similar to the already known to us sexy move, because it starts the same. Right side clockwise, top clockwise, lower a right face back, and push the top face clockwise. Then we return the right side on the top so that this block is assembled. Double turn and lower the right side. The same with the left Sune. Make sure again that it is left Sune. The part is on the left, hold it in the left hand and do the same algorithm but mirrored. Left side counterclockwise, upper side counterclockwise, left side clockwise, upper side counterclockwise again, left side up, double turn of the upper side, and left side down. Same thing again, just like the left sexy move. The fish floats to us, we have a part here, hold it in your left hand, and go. Now that you've learned these two algorithms, let's learn how to apply them. All in all, there can be seven different cases on the yellow side, and now I will show them all to you. Don't worry, they are all solved by the same algorithms. Let's start with the Sune. Our fish, which you already know, it is on the right. We make sure it's right Sune, we're keeping it by the tail on the right side and doing a Sune. As you can see, after this algorithm, we have completely solved yellow side. The left Sune, this is the one that has on the left here a part that looks at us, is done with the left hand. This algorithm solves the left Sune. The following situations can also be solved with Sune. For example, such a situation may arise, which is called ice. due to the fact that all but two yellow parts are assembled, and they look at us both. They are eyes, a pair of yellow eyes. In order to solve eyes, you need to do a right Sune. Then make a double turn. And this is, as you can see, the left Sune. Then next we do the left Sune. Thus, the situation ice was solved thanks to our two Sunes. Moving on. This situation is quite similar to the previous one. All yellow, except for two neighboring ones, are assembled here, but they don't look at us, but to the sides. This situation is called ears or T-case. They should be placed in such a way that they are on the left side, as if they were listening to something. And T-case is also solved with a Sune. First, we do the right Sune. And now, even visually, we can notice that we need to do the left Sune. The yellow side is solved. Moving on. When the yellow side is assembled, except for the two details, but they are not eyes or ears, but are so far apart, this situation is called L case. And it looks like number 8. We should hold the cube so that one detail looks at us and the other to the right. And all we have to do is the same Sune with our right hand. And then we have a Sune again. We make such a turn to fit this part on the left, and then do a Sune with our left hand. The yellow side is solved. The next situation is when none of the corners are up, but if we look at them, they look like eyes and another eyes. It's called double eyes or H case. Let's take a cube so that some eyes look in one direction and others in the opposite direction, left and right. From this position we do right Sune. And another right Sune. The yellow side is solved. The last situation is also with four wrong corners. We have eyes or U case on one side and ears or T case on the other. It's called pie case and I call it helicopter. As if these are its propellers and these are its headlights and this is something else. Write in the comments what it looks like. We hold the cube in such a way that the eyes or headlights of the helicopter look to the left and do again a right Sune. If you look closely, it will be necessary to make such a turn, and this is again a right Sune. And again the yellow side is solved. This stage is solved. As you can see, any case in this supposedly complex stage can be solved by the same algorithm. Sune, right or left. As speedcubers say, if you don't know what to do, do Sune. This stage was a little more difficult than the previous one, and it requires more attention from you. So I urge you to watch it again, just rewind this video. Examine the right Sune, the left Sune, and also attentively examine and record in memory all seven cases that may arise at this stage of solving the yellow side. You will definitely succeed, but be attentive. This concludes the third, most difficult part of our training. Now you can move on to the fourth part, the final one, after which you will definitely learn to fully solve a Rubik's Cube. And don't forget that the best way to thank me is to become my sponsor.